crazy because players like Kyrie or like Kobe or anyone that's really good in the paint, I wouldn't care if they go up for that layup, though. That's the thing. That's crazy. Like, and they probably would still pass it if they see this, but like, if I see Kyrie go up on two defenders like this, in this, like, he got this type of, like, shot, I guess you could say, they'd be like, okay, he went up for a lay. He could still make that very easily, low-key. Videos, Bronny James was absolutely horrendous in his NBA debut. I didn't even know he debuted already. I just saw the clip of him sitting with his dad and like the little interview thing they had. I don't know. But he debuted yesterday, I'm guessing. So we were because this guy right here, hilarious. This dude is hilarious. By Awful Coaching, by the way. That's the dude's name. Just to, you can see it there just to get some premise, bro. But yeah, we can get straight into it.
Bronny James was absolutely horrendous in his preseason debut. This is the first possession he's in the game for. Could we please see ball and man? What on earth is Bronny James doing here? Why is Bronny James on the block right now and his man's on the wing? What was this? Wide open on the first possession. This is just a nothing pass. What is Bronny James doing? Let's get Jackson Hayes to come set a screen at half court and loosen up that defender. He'll have to go under. That'll give you space to operate the offense. What is Bronny James doing here? Like, find Jackson Hayes. Get this screen set. Get that defender off you. Now you can run offense. Instead, you're just standing with the ball at half court, throwing to D'Angelo Russell for no reason. Deflection out of bounds. This is going to be a problem all season long. The defense is not going to care about Bronny James at the three-point line. So when my man goes to help on D'Angelo Russell, I need to be, first of all, at the tip of the three-point line. As soon as he goes to help, I got to cut. I got to cut, get in the lane, collapse defenders, draw extra help, open up for someone else.
Okay.
But, I mean, Bronny James right here, look at this. You're standing three steps beyond the three-point line. You're not cutting right here. You're clogging up space for D'Angelo Russell. You're not getting in the lane. So now the defender can help and then recover. Oh, and then you're going to turn it over. Does Bronny James have any understanding how the pick and roll works right here? Luka Garza is playing level to the screener right here. So I must drag Luka Garza. I got to take three, four, five dribbles downhill. Drag as long as...
Dog, he's like, bro, he is flaming him. Like, it's been a minute and 30 seconds of just on his ass. On his ass. He's just been cooking him this whole time. He do not care.
I'm attacking downhill. Luka Garza's got to stay with me, and it's going to open up Jackson Hayes' role right here. Look at Bronny James. You already picked your dribble up. Get downhill. Keep Luka Garza at the ball to open up Jackson Hayes' role. You already, once you pick your dribble up, which you did instantly, now Luka Garza can recover back to Jackson Hayes, and poof. This cannot be the shot off the pick and roll.
He's like Lester, bro.
Be the shot off the pick and roll. They're in drop coverage here. So again, keep attacking downhill. We've created a two-on-one. So as long as I'm attacking downhill, I got to wait for Garza to commit. If Garza commits to the ball right here, my dribble's got to stay alive. Once he commits to the ball, this is a lob right here.
Okay.
Or if he just stays with Jackson Hayes on the lob right there and you're attacking downhill, then we get a layup. But again, you're already picking your dribble up before Garza's got to commit anywhere. And it's just a flailing runner in the lane. It's...
Bro, they're like after he is so upset. They are down 21 in the second quarter. That is crazy.
I don't understand what Bronny James does offensively. This is a great rip and go drive right here. Look at rip, go, beat your man baseline. So this draws help. Why is Bronny James refused to drop this off to Jackson Hayes? That is a dunk. That is 2 points. That is a dunk. That, look at the help. Drop it off. Drop it off. Why are... This is the look. Again, this is going to be a problem all year long. They don't care about Bronny James in the corner defensively. So when my man steps up to help on D'Angelo Russell, he's not paying attention to you right now. I must cut. So when that help comes, now D'Angelo Russell can drop it off to me for a dunk. Please cut. Okay. Instead, you stand in the corner right here. You're just standing. Let D'Angelo Russell drop that off to you and cut. Instead, you stand in the corner. The defender now can help. Clog D'Angelo Russell's driving lane up. You're just standing in the corner. Turnover. Bronny James does a great...
He is so disappointed, bruh. He is so blown. This is crazy.
Great job defensively chasing over the top of the down screen and then getting skinny and getting over the top of the ball screen. But why is he leaving his feet? You've got a defender in the gaps here. You know that defender's about to step up. The dribble's about to get picked up. Okay. So just slide your feet and guard right here. Look at that. Defender's in the gaps. Dribble's picked up. Just slide your feet and guard. Why on earth are you leaving your feet right here? You're full. Get that. Oh, no. Layup. Not how you switch a screen. I must get underneath the screener. Underneath the screener so I'm ready to guard. And you switch over the top. So now you're fronting right here. And when this player sets a ball screen, he's actually going to end up screening two of you. So now you can't switch. Dunk.
Damn. What? And it's like, bro, he's explaining it. And it's like, just seeing it unfold, it's like, God damn. Did LeBron play any of this? Like, did he play
at
all?
What is Bronny James doing on the floor if he's not coming off this screen right here? You can see the Timberwolves are in drop coverage. Please come off the screen and get in the lane. This big is going to end up dropping. You can see it happen. He's going to end up dropping. The roll's going to be open. Look at Bronny James right here. Why are you not... Ah! Why are you not getting downhill off this screen? Create that 2-on-1. Easy 2. You're not even trying. You're passing the ball before anything happens. And now, just 1-on-1, ISO, and then whatever that is. Bronny James.
God, who shot that? Who shot that?
And whatever that is.
Oh, my goodness. He's shooting like me. What's wrong with him?
Bronny James just gets lost defensively so many times. He actually does a great job here. Nice job. Look at that. Get in the gaps. Stunt. Recover. This is great one-on-one defense. One problem that doesn't end once this pass gets made. Could we stay with who we're guarding? Stay with who you're guarding. Why is Bronny James standing in the lane for absolutely no reason? You end up screening your own man right here. Wide open three. Bronny James just cannot stop clogging the floor for his teammates. Why is he 5 steps from the three-point line? Get to the three-point line so I'm at least a threat. Look at this. Because, again, my man's coming to help. So-
yeah, I see. Yeah, you're not Curry. See, like, Curry being right there, that's different. Yeah. Instead of Curry having to go in there, the defender better step up. There's a difference. That's crazy. That's crazy when you think about it. Because, like, realistically, if that's Stephen Curry that far out, that's nothing really. He shoot from that far like a lot of time, like, bro, that's normal. So the defender, you it wouldn't be him yapping about you. It'd be the defender having to step up to guard you from that far. But since they know that you're not a threat from that far, especially from that far or even at the three, it's just like, I'm gonna just stay right here.
So if I'm at
which
the
is crazy, and I don't even watch basketball enough to be talking or play enough to be talking, like, professionally, but, like, just from, like, a bystander just watching, I see what he's saying. That's all I'm saying.
I could catch and shoot, or I could cut right here when my man steps up to help. Boom, I'm gone.
Oh, I see what you mean. He right there. If Bronny just cuts, that's a free pass right there to the lane. You go for the lay. If you get fouled, go for the free throw shot, whatever, you vibed out. I see.
Now I'm collapsing. Other defenders drawing help from other places and opening up the floor for somebody else.
Yeah.
But Bronny James, look at that. You're 7 steps from the three-point line. So the defender can help, recover. You just clogged up space again and nothing. Now off the pick and roll, Bronny James, they just switched. You have a massive mismatch down low. Center against a guard down low. Please pull this dribble back right here and attack this mismatch in the paint. How did we get this incredible switch, incredible mismatch, and this is the shot you get? Wow. Just basic right here.
The breathing out there. It's like, bro, you relax. It's okay. It's okay. You're not his dad. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. I know people get real serious about sports. They get more serious about sports than religion. Ain't that? Yeah, it gets serious. That parlay. You think anybody had a parlay on Bronny?
Bronny James blows by his man off the dribble. That's wonderful. So now a second defender is coming to step up. I'm not trying to finish through four different arms right here. The weak side of the floor is wide open. I have got to kick this for a catch and shoot three. Look at Bronny James. Stop. Why am I trying to finish over two defenders? The three-point line is wide open. That help, you know it's coming from somewhere.
That's crazy because players like Kyrie or like Kobe or anyone that's really good in the paint, I wouldn't care if they go up for that layup though. That's the thing. That's crazy. Like, and they probably would still pass it if they see this, but like if I see Kyrie go up on two defenders like this, in this, like he got this type of like shot, I guess you could say. They'd be like, okay, he went up for a lay. He could still make that very easily, low key.
Look to the weak side of the floor. Nope. Smack. Bronny James's refusal to ever get layups is unbelievable. Your man is not paying attention to you and is walking back. Please sprint. Please run your lane here. Get in the lane. I'm drawing help from someone else. Look at sprint. Get downhill. Now that pass gets made, I draw help from someone else. Dalton connects, gonna end up being wide open, but you're standing.
I see. Damn. Because if he ran like that, damn. Like, I know it kind of sounds like I'm just reiterating what he's saying, but it's like, it's just me, like, understanding it. If he just, like, ran down, yeah, you'd have forced him to kind of have to come closer to you and guard you, and that would have kept him open on, like, the... Fuck, what is it called, bro? I'm losing my basketball knowledge, bro. I forgot. But just, like, as they're coming down the lane, it would have forced him having to guard you, because now you're a threat just coming down this way. So now, bro right here who had the ball could just beam it to him. Easy three.
Damn, so again, it's help, recover, you don't make the defense pay. Here it is again. Bronny James refuses to get layups. Your man, I don't even know what that defender's doing. Leaving his feet to gamble. Okay, please sprint here. Please sprint. Please get a layup. Please. Look at this. Why am I standing? Now! Go! Now! Go! Like, that defender's got to step up on the ball. If I'm running my lane, that's a dunk. That's a dunk. That's a dunk. That's a dunk.
Oh, okay.
That's a dunk, but you stand. And now the defense gets back in the play, and it's another turnover.
Jesus. This man is losing it, bro.
This is just an all-time atrocious defensive possession. You're guarding the ball. My only focus is the ball. Look at Bronny James's eyes right here. Look at him leaning, searching for a screen. So, of course, you're going to get blown by baseline. But, all right, the play's not over right here. Could we get right back to who we're guarding? Right back to who we're guarding. Why are you standing in the paint guarding air, giving up another open three?
Oh my goodness, bro. He is not having it, bro. What I hate about Bronny's play is it's at least 80% effort. He played like his minutes are guaranteed. standing around already. Damn, he's clearly been watching his dad. This is the AC. I remember too many Caitlin Clark games was making him soft. This is embarrassing, truly embarrassed. How the kid was able to make it to this level of incompetence. I've never seen a player literally walk during live action play. It's clearly this is a dog or pony show for making history. Father, son hit the floor together. They'll have their moment, and Bronny will be put out the league in 3 years. JJ Redick claims he likes what he saw and is happy with his progress. Dave, man, he getting flamed.
Enjoyed that video. Right. Make sure to check out another video like that. You know, just click it. Click it right here. You don't got a sub or nothing, bro. I'm making it easy. Just click the video. It's on your screen already. Might as well. Go ahead, click it.